the most athletic point guard we've seen in this game since Dr. Naismith hung that first peach basket.
Turner was the National Player of the Year and is an incredibly versatile player. A superior athlete, very explosive off the floor, a guy that can rebound and block shots. No one was more productive per minute as a big guy in college basketball last year than Cousins. Welcome to a special edition of Raptors Today. Paul Jones and Sherman Hamilton here. The upcoming NBA draft, only a couple of days away, Sherm. And I believe the word that Brian Colangelo used was uncertainty, but we know one thing's for certain. The Washington Wizards have the first pick.
Well, they do, and they're going to need it. After the season they've had with Gilbert Arenas, they moved Antoine Jameson. They need to get some good vibes. Their Caron Butler's gone. They need a good pick that's going to revitalize that organization. New ownership there as well, so it's going to be interesting to see how this draft works out for them throughout this year.
All right, Washington, Philly, New Jersey, Minnesota, and Sacramento. There's your top five, and then after that, I'm sure somebody will wreck the draft. When it gets down to 13, Sherm, you take a look at some of the previous number 13 picks, some pretty good names. Kobe Bryant, Karl Malone, although in the last 4 or 5 years, with the Raptors picking 13 this year, it hasn't been that much of a boon.
Well, it hasn't been. You can also throw Richard Jefferson's name in there as a previous 13 overall pick. But for the Raptors, again, you're going to have to judge what player can you get at that pick that can help your franchise. If not, you've got to consider all the other scenarios in terms of moving up in the draft, trying to package that pick, maybe moving back if you see a player that you want down the road. But a lot of options are available because in this draft, after that fifth pick, you can pretty much get what you want in terms of everybody being on an equal playing field talent-wise from most part, and from 5, say, to 25. So after that fifth pick, everything goes. And for the Raptors, you've got to keep everything in play. You cannot lock off any decision because you never know what's going to work out. As you know, draft day, a lot of craziness can happen. You've got to be prepared to move.
Well, Sherm, the other thing that impacts draft day, I think, is the impending free agency. Yep. There are a lot of big names out there, and those names might be, well, pieces or considerations when you make a move to move up or move down or, you know, get rid of a pick, so to speak.
Well, you're right, and that's why you can't be locked in. You've got to be ready and be flexible. I mean, the decisions that you're going to make throughout this draft process are going to be unique because of the free agency, because of the fact that this franchise itself has to figure out some things about their impending free agent and Chris Bosh. So you've got to be ready to think on your feet. Brian Colangelo has done that in the past. He's been ready to react, and he's got to be a guy who's going to initiate some things, but also in the background, be ready to make the moves necessary and kind of scrap the game plan if he needs to.
All right, let's talk about some of the guys that we know that will be up there. John Wall looks like he's going to be the number one pick. First time ever that a man wearing big blue from Kentucky will be the number one overall pick, and kind of stunning, Sherm, when you think about the pedigree of that program and all the great players that have gone through there. Philadelphia, looks like Evan Turner might be their guy.
I like Evan Turner. I mean, he comes into the game, I think, most NBA ready in terms of his size, his game. He can shoot the ball. He can break you down and play that mid-range game as well. And he kind of reminds me of Brandon Roy in the sense that when Brandon Roy came into the league, he had all facets of his game going. So he was just going to be a player that the league had to deal with. Evan Turner has some of that in his game. But John Wall, the number one overall pick, dynamic talent, speed, strength, gets to the basket, finishes, just like those Derrick Roses, the guys who get excitement into the game end to end. That's what John Wall brings. Now, his leadership in terms of being a point guard on the NBA level is going to be tested, but we've seen Derrick Rose step up in that area, so there's no reason why this young man can't do it as well. But I like his explosiveness. When guys can get up and down the floor and finish around the hoop like he can, they bring a lot of excitement to the game.
Well, another guy that potential abound is Derek Favors, like a kid out of Georgia Tech, Sherm. And there have been some comparisons to him in terms of his physical stature with Dwight Howard in terms of his vertical leap and his wingspan. But again, you're basing all of this on potential.
Right, and potential can get you hired or get you fired. And this kid, Derek Favors, definitely has a good ceiling to work with. He's got that physical ability that we talked about. Dwight Howard, now that's a different type of physical ability, but you're right. The springs, the reaction, all those things that you really can't teach. You can only work on them, but you can't teach. He has that. The kid's got potential to be a very good player in the league. It's just about, does that potential become realized or unrealized throughout his career?
Sherm, another guy long on, well, athleticism and length.
Syracuse Orange, Wesley Johnson.
I like his game. I mean, he played banged up pretty much the whole season for Syracuse. But when he was going, he was a tough player to stop. And we're talking about a guy who can affect the game from the three-point line to the mid-range game and finishing around the basket as well. I think he's got a lot of skill to be on this level, and effective skill. As the court opens up in the NBA, a guy like Wesley Johnson can have a lot of success because he has the handle and he can finish above the rim.
Well, sure, I was going to ask you that. There are a lot of guys that are fit for the NBA.
Yes.
And the college game actually restricts them in a sense, and they get into the pros, they get a little bit of freedom, and they get to spread their wings. Wesley Johnson obviously fits into that category in your eyes.
100% I agree with that, Jonesy. I think when he gets to the NBA, as he learns the game, he's going to figure out how his skill set is going to fit in and how effective he can be with that open floor that he
right.
gets to work with. He's explosive. He can shoot the ball from 18 feet. He can shoot it from the three-point line, and he can also pass the ball. He can be one of those pseudo swing guards. You can play the 1-2-3 with him, and he'll be effective as an NBA player. He's got to get a bit stronger. That's going to come with his game, but I think for the NBA, Wesley Johnson's game is more suited than for college.
All right, quick question before we leave Johnson. The fact that they played a lot of zone at Syracuse, does that hurt him from a defensive standpoint moving forward into the NBA?
Well, I think it could, but we see a lot of teams in the NBA play various forms of a zone, so he'll have an understanding on that level. But, I mean, he's going to go through the workouts. He's going to have a preseason to figure it out. And defensively, he's got the athleticism, I think. Will he commit to it and get it done on a day-to-day basis? That's going to be his decision. But if he can do it offensively from an athletic standpoint, there's no question that he should be able to do it on the defensive end. Bigger, stronger in the NBA, but he should be able to acclimate himself to the speed of this game because he's pretty quick himself.
All right, let's get to DeMarcus Cousins. We talked about John Wall, a Kentucky guy, going number one, another member of Big Blue, DeMarcus Cousins. And this kid's big on talent, Sherm, but there are some question marks around him.
There are, and DeMarcus Cousins, obviously a wide body, eats up a lot of space, can finish around the basket, but from an athletic standpoint, he is not the best guy. I mean, we're talking about a guy who can't elevate off the floor extremely well. The fact that he eats up space is a good thing, but in the NBA, those bodies around the basket, they need to be elevated over, and I don't think he has that at this point. But he definitely has a knack for scoring around the basket. Now, his athleticism might come into play in terms of being able to elevate over some of those bigger bodies, but I think he can move you out with those
yeah.
big shoulders, that wide butt. He can create space, and I think that's how he's going to have to play the game on the NBA level.
Got to love the draft and all the anticipation and potential that it brings. When we come back, we'll hear from the Toronto Raptors' big shooters, Jim Kelly, Director of Scouting, Masai Ujiri, Assistant General Manager, and President and General Manager, Brian Colangelo. All that when Raptors Today rolls on.